One take, I'm a busy man. Let's talk about all the Mod 6 and the Resourceful Bees as it's implemented in this pack. When you start Resourceful Bees, you will find these bee houses around the world. You can just mine them up. And typically, this is how you start. You find bees that spawn in the world, put them in there. They harvest the resource that that bee likes. You can tell what resource the bee likes by right-clicking on it in JEI. And under the bee flowers, you will see a scrolling list of everything that they will pollinate. Most types of bees will have only one thing that they pollinate. Though the closer you are to the base tier, the more... Like, this will take anything that is cobblestone adjacent. You put it in there, the bees do their thing, they make honey, you get honeycombs, and that is how you progress through the other tiers of apiary. I suggest ignoring all of that. What you actually want to do is find a villager, capture him using any of the mob capturing tools available to you in the All the Mod 6 mod pack, and if you place an oak bee nest in their paddock, whatever you want to call it, they will become a beekeeper villager, which you can then trade with them using emeralds to trade beeswax blocks, honeycomb, everything that you need pretty much to make the tier 1 apiary. I would ignore bees entirely until you have a tier 1 apiary. It's not that hard to make. Villagers will refresh their trades twice a day. I've disabled the day-night cycle so that he won't be refreshing his anytime soon. Next. Bees, where to find them? There are different tiers of bees. Tier 1 are bees that spawn in the world. These are things like quartz bees, cob bees, and lava bees. You can tell if a bee is a natural world spawn by right-clicking them in JEI. And here it will say spawns in world, true. If you click the arrows here, it will tell you all of the different biomes where you can find them. I personally recommend getting a nature's compass to help you locate these biomes. Shattered savanna, these can be found in, so right-click on the Nature's Compass, Shattered Savanna, plug that in, search, and if the biome exists in the world, it will show you where the closest one is. Just follow it, find the bees. Very simple. Tier 2 is bee breeding. Bee breeding typically takes two types of bees that spawn naturally in the world, like, say, lava and ka bees, and some type of material that they need to breed. Take them over to the apiary breeder. You can tell what materials they need to breed by, again, right-clicking on the bee, and one of these columns will be bee breeding. Click on that, and you can see that lava bee plus ka bee equals stoned bee. And this material beneath them is what is consumed to breed the bees. Think of this as the wheat or carrot replacement that you would use to breed a vanilla mob. This is what they eat in order to produce this. And this percentage chance here is the success rate. You have a 60% chance to get the offspring here and a 40% chance for effectively a failed breed where you get nothing out of it. At lower tiers, this effectively means nothing because the materials that you put into them are very easy to get, but it can be frustrating the further up you get because the materials that you need to feed them are expensive. So, as an example, we will open up our apiary breeder. These are breed time upgrades. I recommend crafting them so that you don't have to wait around as long. You put B1 here, B2 here, food for B here, food for B here, and then you wait for them to breed. And if they are successful, they will output their offspring into the apiary storage unit. And that's really all there is to bee breeding. You either are successful or you're not. And if you're not, you try again. The next tier of bees are mutations, which, as far as I'm aware, is a new thing in this current version of this iteration of Resourceful Bees. So netherite bees are the first time, I believe, that most players will experience this. What you need to do is put a gold bee into your apiary, import it, unlock, put the typical resource that the bee wants to pollinate in here, and then put the mutate criteria in here as well. You can check what this is by going to the bee here In this case, we're trying to make a netherite bee, so we click on the gold bee. And one of the tabs here will be block to item mutations. Click on this, and we can see that a gold bee that pollinates a block of netherite will have an 80% chance to turn that into a cobblestone, but a 20% chance to turn that into a netherite spawn egg. This is the one that we're trying to get. It will take several times for most of you. It took me more than 5 times, so I got unlucky. But this is how you get the top tier bees. Here we saw that they did the mutation, and I got really lucky. We got the 20% and got the netherite spawn egg. So, yeah, that's really all there is to it. If you're having trouble finding out which bees come from which mutations, don't search for the bee in JEI. Like, if I try to search up netherite bee here, right-click, nothing in this UI will tell you where this comes from. You want to search for the spawn egg, which will show you the block to item mutation. Gold bee with this criteria will give you the spawn egg. And that's really it as far as bees go. There's 3 ways to get bees. They either spawn in the world, you breed them in the apiary, or you mutate them. And if you're trying to find the way that you mutate something, search for the bee's spawn egg, not for the bee itself. Small tip, if you're trying to deal with honey runoff, like if you have a lot of bees and are producing a lot of honeycombs, and you have a lot of honey that you don't want to use the bottle method to turn it into honey blocks, pipe out of your centrifuge into this blast chiller from the thermal series, and that will just turn it into liquid honey, freeze it using power, and spits out the honey blocks. Makes it very easy. That's really all there is to bees. So I hope you found this useful. Cheers.